We're observing the reaction between aluminum and copper 2 chloride. Let's take a closer look.
Aluminum has 3 valence electrons.
Copper's 2 valence electrons are transferred to the 2 chloride atoms that have 7 valence electrons each. When the ionic bond is formed, both copper and chloride have complete octets. The end result is 1 copper for every 2 chloride. I wipe my brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals. I'm breaking in, shaping up, then checking out on the prison bus. This is it, the apocalypse. The reaction results in the formation of copper, which has 2 valence electrons and is in a solid state.
Aluminum and chloride combine to form an aqueous solution. For every 1 aluminum atom, there are 3 chloride atoms.
Next, we'll look at a particle diagram of the reaction.
As you can see, aluminum is a solid metal that is represented by the purple lifesaver.
Copper chloride is an aqueous solution. Copper is represented by green and chloride by yellow.
When the two substances combine, the chloride is attracted to the aluminum in groups of 3. The copper is left as a solid.
Let's watch the reaction.
As you can see, the aluminum foil appears to be turning a red color. In reality, this is the formation of the solid copper.
Our final result was a red solid copper and a clear aqueous solution.